Welcome to this introduction to the brand new Dataplex catalog, which was released just days ago as of this recording. Dataplex is fundamentally about unifying data management, including metadata, lineage, and cataloging. In the past, cataloging wasn't always a smooth experience, but that's about to change with the significant step forward in metadata management and organization of data assets on Google Cloud. The new Dataplex catalog is particularly useful for Google Cloud customers, especially those using data products like BigQuery. However, it's also beneficial for managing external data sources. While BigQuery integrates seamlessly with this service, Dataplex can accommodate other assets such as cloud storage and even external databases. You can create third-party assets called entities in Dataplex, which merge into a centralized catalog metadata layer and lineage system. Let's start our hands-on tutorial by loading some data into our project. This approach allows you to follow along even if you don't have existing assets, and it's ideal for testing in a sandbox environment before moving to production. We'll use the Cloud Shell and its editor for initial data loading, as it's a free service that's easy to use and well integrated into the console. First, we'll create a BigQuery script using a Python library called Faker to generate synthetic data for a business table. If Faker isn't available in your Cloud Shell IDE, we'll need to install it. We'll set up the necessary environment variables, including your Google project ID and dataset name. Remember to enable BigQuery API if you haven't used it in your project before. After creating the dataset in BigQuery, we'll run our script to populate the table with fake data. As an alternative to BigQuery, we can also use a cloud storage bucket, which is typical for semi-structured or unstructured data, but can still hold analytic potential. With our data in place, it's time to explore the fascinating world of Dataplex. It's important to note that Dataplex isn't just about cataloging. It also allows you to set up dictionaries and glossaries for consistent terminology, schedule data profiling scans, and perform data quality checks. However, for this introduction, we'll focus primarily on the new Dataplex catalog. The heart of the new Dataplex catalog is the Aspects feature, which allows for more complex and advanced metadata information for your data assets. These aspects are predefined structures for metadata, unlike the previous freeform tagging system. They provide a more controlled and organized approach to metadata management. When we navigate to the Dataplex catalog, we'll see some default aspects already in place. These aspects can be used for powerful filtering and searching capabilities. For example, we can easily filter to show just BigQuery tables or other specific asset types. One of the most significant improvements in the new Dataplex catalog is its search functionality. There's a new, more structured language for searching through this additional, richer metadata. This allows for more complex and precise queries across your data assets. Let's dive deeper into setting up these aspects. We can create custom aspect types, which are essentially schemas for metadata. For instance, we might create an aspect type for a MongoDB database. In this aspect, we can define fields like team as a required text field, and collections as an optional array of collection names. This structured approach allows for consistent metadata across similar assets and enables more powerful searching and filtering capabilities. addition to aspects, Dataplex also introduces the concept of entity types. These are essentially types of data assets, like a MongoDB database. We can attach required aspect types to these entity types, ensuring that all assets of a particular type have the necessary metadata. We can even set up aliases, allowing for implementation-agnostic names for data assets. It's worth noting that it may take some time for your asset to be indexed and appear in the Dataplex catalog. This indexing process happens in the background, so don't be alarmed if you don't see your assets immediately after setting them up. To keep this video succinct, we better end our video there, but be sure to subscribe for additional GCP-related news and tutorials. The data loading scripts and diagram files are in the description, and we'll keep an eye on the comment section for any questions. Thanks for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.